Hello and welcome back to RimWorld, episode 2. This is Kendi. I've been thinking about this and I'm coming across this problem. I can get some good defenses up here on the north side and have them do a whole bunch of stuff, mine through, do a bunch of traps. The south side, I've been wondering what the heck to do. And so I can't really put the electricity kind of stuff here is because if they do decide they want to come around this way, and I can't completely wall it off because they can just come through here and you can't build on the very edge of the map. I was wondering if somehow I can build a bunch of walls up to a certain point here and then maybe do a little windy thing and then they come out through here and this would be our secondary thing. So I think I'll map that out and see what people think about that. Our little llama's still there. I was also looking, unfortunately, on characters. I went through and got decent stuff, but none of them can do animals really well. So that leaves getting that wolf done and that kind of thing. The thing I didn't think about was our main storage, and I'm thinking, well, you can build houses on here, but you can't do the gardening stuff on the sand, so why not build encased storage over here? This room's already here. I was thinking about maybe building some more rooms here. It won't take up much ground there. And that would mean I'd also have to knock off a chunk around here, save this for later. It would give me a secondary growing zone, but I was thinking of sticking the power somewhere in here. You can manage to dig a little bit in, and then you can get some of your power, and you can remove part of the rock, but once you go in, like, three squares or something, it seems that you can't remove the roof, so I might be able to stick a little bit in here. So our builder, who we have building, so she's building that stuff. They've been also having him take the stuff to the stockpile. That's okay. We did have some meals up here, just random meals on the map, so he must have already taken care of it, and that's why he's doing the steel now. I probably want to I could probably do this first, is get some of the trees down here. I don't want to cut the plants, I want to cut the trees. I don't want to cut down all of the trees. I like having them there. People like having them there. It adds to the beauty and all that jazz. But if I'm going to try doing some sort of traps, something up here, I'm going to want to clear out that area. Oh, there's tons of trees here. I'm thinking about planting trees as well. I do need them to build a little extra there. That looks like either there was a wall or maybe there's a little room in there. The big room on the map is down in the southeast, yeah. Okay, got a group of visitors, which is actually really one person. Oh no, there's two people. Sometimes it's one. And they're from Toron Village. And they're at 31. I thought about putting in the hospitality suite mod, but then if you don't really get your suites built, like, really soon, then you start getting negative faction thing. I don't know if they fixed that with Alpha 17, if they updated it or not, but it makes it kind of difficult at the beginning. Anyone primarily mining. She's still building, which is okay. Let's see, there's the dog. I have the names on the dogs, so I could kind of get a good idea of where it is at. Okay, so she's doing that. So now we're at the end of the second day? Yeah. They kind of changed up the time frames a little bit. They kind of have changed from different alphas of having each month and maybe have a couple days in a month, or then changing it to 10-day cycles for, or 15-day cycles for each season. And they kind of changed the name a little bit too. Okay. I'm really going to have to design this out. I do want to capture a decent amount of land while trying not to use all of our resources. There is a door here, so we could get around and stuff there. We can chop down a few of those trees. Probably that. That one looks like it's probably too small and it's just not operating. We'll also want to try to flatten that. I think that might work well enough. It is springtime, so usually you get like a negative penalty if you build something outside, like the production tables, and now it's not quite so bad. But I really do want to get some stone started. Got a bunch of chunks right there. Alright, so it's almost nighttime. She's going back in. They're cutting down a few of those. That's okay. Okay, she's doing her, relaxation there. Okay, I'm gonna have him quick go in here. She's a little bit cranky. If I can clean up her room, it might make her a little bit happier tonight. Come on, come back here. Gotta catch him fast enough. Alright, so he's got one more. Turn that off, that would probably help. I don't think. After a while, they just kind of refuse to do anything. And she won't do anything either. Alright, let's speed it up for the night. So we have a teeny bit of bricks built up here. Not much to count for anything. At least we have our main walls done. Just barely started on that. Got that one doubled up. Got a little bit of wood stored there. I mean, sometimes it's useful to go and get these and reclaim all the stone, but they're kind of far away, so I wouldn't really bother with it. I do have a bunch of friendly deer here, but we don't have any of the kitchen stuff set up yet. I think I will go ahead and just kind of put that down and let's see. takes 100 steel, 2 components, and this is 100 steel and 3 components. Personally, I think it's worth it for an extra component. We do have a ship chunk here, and then I think I've seen a couple other. They're kind of nice to get the components from, and then we got a couple, probably one there and definitely there. There are the little funky brown stuff sticking out there. Maybe some there. Yeah, compact machinery. And then of course this will be useful when we can get into turrets, so that will be good too. Where is she? She's getting wood. No one is nearby. I don't want that to spoil. I have much to begin with. We do have 30 medicine. It is pretty good to start off with. But if we just happen to get the flu or something, some sort of disease kind of thing that we have to keep using it, it kind of sucks, and you need to make sure you have enough to get through it. Do not have a way through there. So as soon as that gets walled off, they're gonna have to walk around the other way, and there's our mad animal. And it's a little rat there. He unfortunately is way out there. This rat, you can click on them and it says it's going after her. So let's have her start kind of running away from it, sort of. She's got 0 shooting skill. Lovely. That's because he couldn't use it at all. So I really don't expect her to be able to do much of anything here. But prefer her to not get hurt. So I gotta kind of bring it back through the trees, kite the little rat, and then hopefully not get shot at either. Alright, nope. Let's have her go down. There we go. And the little X, he's dead. She can go ahead and they can both be unrecruited, so they can do whatever they need to do. Oh good, he's gonna go up there and grab those 3. Don't think there's any else on the map. And nothing really of note to pick up. I don't know, sometimes there's some interesting things. There's more components down here. Some there. So we're gonna have a decent amount of components. The plasteels, I really like it because it makes the turrets be a little bit more durable there. So our security, we don't have it yet, but that's okay. Okay, she's cutting down the tree, and we're already getting to the end of the next day. Okay, they've both been doing some hauling. I think I'm gonna need to stick one of them on some mining here, I think. Okay, so he's gonna start digging that out. Alright, so let's... I don't usually play pre-plan, but that's because I usually kind of actually mine out the area opposed to putting down the planning. But there we go. Plan stuff. So if we had people come around this side, you can see that you can't build on this area over here. If they came around here, kind of thinking that they come in and kind of zigzag in. That gives them enough time to kind of get in a single file line. Not too much, just enough. And so it's also not too thin on the side. And I was possibly thinking right over the water, because that would mean that they would be slower. And if I really want to, I can end up putting some traps or put some traps down here. That would give me some space to put down some turrets here. But of course that would mean I'm going to have to try to put a whole bunch of walls and stuff over here. I'm just not sure it would work. And I'd probably have to have like a door and leave it open here. That way that they will see this as a way to get through. I don't know if they would rather go through this way or go around in the water. I might have to actually make this more straight, because if this is maybe a shorter route, they might do that. I probably will need to do that, is my guess. So if going here is going to be shorter than going this direction, that might work. Definitely, if I put it over here. I was just hoping to give them more time by going this way, but I want it to work. And if that's the stipulation, is that the distance is shorter going through here, then I'm going to have to do it that way. Or maybe even I do it up through here. I don't know. Someone's gonna have to tell me. That is kind of a secondary thing, but something does kind of need to be in place somewhat soon. Just because I'm gonna start to have trouble with the invaders at some point. Speaking of, I need to hold that one open. And then we can start also working on our second layer. And then we can get some over here. And then I would like to finish it so they come on the sand. And that way I can do the growing zones of trees. Probably I'll need to reinforce that a little bit more, I guess. Not gonna be able to grow much in there, could, but I think a little bit of is rich soil, so I probably wanna leave it for crops. I can start a small one of trees, and each of the trees are a little bit different. Oh, they're getting ready to go to bed. Oak trees. The growing time's 30 days on that. The poplar is shorter, but I think that the yield out of it, you don't get as much. Yeah. It's not as much useful. But it'll grow faster. Pine trees are 20 days. Which may work the best. I don't know why the nutrition's better. I don't know, pine sap, pine cones, who knows. Birch trees, that's 20 days too. The teaks, those take a little bit longer. They do have more nutrition, okay. are pretty, so I like that. And I think this is, yeah, the jungle trees. They're like the poplar. They're not that good. I'm gonna try the pine trees for there. Let's zoom in and grab these. Alright, so those are selected. What would be a good place? I usually like to keep my stockpiles kind of close, but there's not that many good ones here. Well, for now, we'll just stick them there. I don't want any corpses. Just the chunks. Okay, so go ahead and get that going to the morning. So we're gonna need a bunch of doors here. I'm not gonna start with too many of them. Security. Let's get. Those take 70, so yeah. And are still at 888. I think I'll go ahead and start with a few of those. The wood is great if you want to try to just hurt someone. I didn't mean to do that. if you want to hurt them and capture them, that seems to work pretty good. Has this done, which she got the outside and then can't go through. You have to go around the opposite direction. Eventually you'll have to put in another row or two or whatever of stone walls. So if she gets to that next section. Man, she has too many skills on there. That's unfortunate. Alright, let's also start getting stockpile stuff going here. So this is what I would always have to try to do specialized stockpiles, and it kind of sucks. At least here, don't have to do that. Oh, I bet that added to it. Let's delete that, make it smaller. Start that and then expand it. So we got that kind of thing down. This is, I'm assuming, yeah, for dead animals. So let's go ahead and stick a bit of that in there. Removing the medicines, thus you got the low medicine kind of thing there. Actually, we'll want to. Ooh, I haven't seen that before. Interesting. I don't know if the animals will eat it. I hope not. Let's look at that. It is ambrosia fruit. Oh, slightly addictive. Oh, that's great. Alright, so that's in pretty much the smack dab in the middle of the area. Not sure if that is just a random thing that will occur once, or if these plants will stay there forever and ever. I don't know. I'll have to see about that. How is our plants? We are at 80 on some of it. Okay, so some of it is on rich soil, so some of the stuff over here and then over here is not. Likewise, the potatoes are starting to grow. Got a little bit of that in the rich soil as well. A little bit of the strawberries there. So they're cutting down a bunch of trees, which is going to help. Because the stockpile, that's right, is over there. Okay, let's do one of these. Let's copy the settings and paste it there. And not forbid, I want the stockpile to delete that, so that way they'll move it to there. Okay, Tao. He likes growing, not really likes growing, but so far, that's okay. We need to... Oh, that's almost done. That is good to know. Okay, she is working on that. But it is taking a while to go around here. Unfortunately, how much is needed left in here? Okay, so she's carrying the steel. She's gonna need 3 components. It's almost nighttime. I may consider just having her mine, or deconstruct that. Let's deconstruct that. Alright. She wants to play, apparently. She doesn't really need to play. So that has everything there. And we got a little bit of dirt and stuff there. So maybe I can have him clean up a little bit. Oh, we still have a spot here. Whoops. Oh, we don't have another bed. That could explain maybe why he's a little bit crankier than... Actually, he's the happy one. Hey, that works out. He has a good mood. Alright. So, we are starting the 5th day. She's finally getting back. Oh no. I did not pay attention. So... Ooh. I kind of need her to prioritize hauling that. I really do not like having components left out in the weather. They're pretty hard to get, and they cost a lot if you do get them from a vendor or a traveling person, or if you go and buy them yourself. Don't want to lose those. They're pretty valuable. Okay, so they're not going around that way. They're going that way. Distance and having to have them walk does take a lot of time and effort, and yeah. Let's make sure for the next day they get that in. And, yeah. Okay, so we'll get the electricity finished, which means then we can get this refrigerated and then get the kitchen started. Do need to still finish this bit up, just so it's enclosed and no raiders come in and smash the generator. but we'll start having a bunch of food here pretty soon, which is a good positive thing. And we at least have all of our borders encased, and then still try to figure out how's the best way to path through this. And gonna need to get a little bit of walls up or something so that the shooting can be directly into the back of this room. Yeah. So thanks for watching. See you next time.